Hello, Daniel Delkowski here from howtomechatronics.com. In this tutorial, we will learn how to connect a liquid crystal display or LCD to the Arduino board. LCDs like this are very popular and broadly used in electronic projects as they are good for displaying information like sensors data from your project, and also they are very cheap. We can start this tutorial with the pinout of the LCD. It has 16 pins, and the first one from left to right is the ground pin. The second pin is the VCC, which we connect to the 5 volts pin on the Arduino board. Next is the VO pin, on which we can attach a potentiometer for controlling the contrast of the display. Next comes the RS pin or register select pin, which is used for selecting whether we will send commands or data to the LCD. For example, if the RS pin is set on a low state or 0 volts, then we are sending commands to the LCD like set the cursor to a specific location, clear the display, turn off the display, and so on. And if the RS pin is set on a high state or 5 volts, then we are sending data or characters to the LCD. Next comes the RW pin, which selects the mode whether we will read or write to the LCD. Here the write mode is obvious, and it is used for writing or sending commands and data to the LCD. The read mode is used by the LCD itself when executing the program, which we don't have a need to discuss about it in this tutorial. Next is the E-pin, which enables the writing to the registers, or the next 8 data pins from DO to D7. So through these pins we are sending the 8 bits data when we are writing to the registers, or for example, if we want to see the letter uppercase A on the display, we will send 0100000 to the registers according to the ASCII table. And the last two pins, A and K, or anode and cathode, are for the LED backlight. Okay, so after all, we don't have to worry much about how the LCD works, as the liquid crystal library takes care for almost everything. From the Arduino official website, you can find and see the functions of the library, which enable easy use of the LCD. We can use the library in a 4 or 8 bit mode. In this tutorial, we will use it in a 4-bit mode, or we will just use 4 of the 8 data pins. Before we write the code, let's see the circuit schematic first. I will use an Arduino Mega board, 1K potentiometer, and a LCD. So we will use just 6 digital input pins from the Arduino board, the LCD's registers from D4 to D7 will be connected to the Arduino's digital pins from 4 to 7. The enable pin will be connected to pin number 2, and the RS pin will be connected to pin number 1. The RW pin will be connected to ground, and the VO pin will be connected to the potentiometer. Okay, so now we can write some code for the LCD. First thing we need to do is to include the liquid crystal library. We do it from here, sketch, include library, liquid crystal. Okay, then we will create a liquid crystal object like this. I will name it LCD, and as a parameters we will set the pins number on the Arduino respectively to the circuit schematic. So the first parameter is for the RS pin, and as we connect it to the digital pin number 1, I will write here 1. The second parameter is the enable pin, and that one we connected to the digital pin number 2 on the Arduino board. And the next parameters are for the registers. So first is the for the register D4, and that's connected to pin number 4. Then the D5, D6 and D7. So just like this. Okay. Next is the setup, where we will initialize the LCD and set dimensions. So we do it like this, lcd.begin and set the dimension of the LCD 16x2. Okay, and now in the loop we will write our main program. First, let's print something on the LCD using the print function, like this, lcd.print. I will print Arduino and make a delay of 3 seconds so that we can notice it. Okay. Now using the setCursor function, we can change the location on the display where the next text will be written. So lcd.setCursor. And the first parameter is for the column and the second is for the row. So I will change the cursor to the second column and first row. So this actually will be the second row, as the this number starts from 0. So 0 1, that will be the second row. And I will write something again using the print function. I will write LCD tutorial. Okay. And I will set 3 seconds delay again. Okay, after these two texts, we will clear the display using the clear function, lcd.clear. Okay, now using the blink function, we can set the blinking cursor like this, lcd.blink. I will add some delay so we can notice it. I will change again the location of the cursor. So we can have a, so we can see that blinking cursor on a different location, like this, and again some delay, 3 seconds. Okay, we can also turn off this blinking cursor using the no blink function. This will turn off the blinking cursor. And we can also set a different cursor, like underscore cursor, using the lcd.cursor function. I will add some delay so we can notice it. And using the no cursor function, we can turn off the underscore cursor as well. Okay, and now we'll clear once again the display using the clear function. And that will be our main program, which will repeat all the time. And now let's see how it works. So here is the first text, and after some delay, the second text on a different location. Here's the blinking cursor, and again, after some delay, the blinking cursor on a different location, and the underscore cursor. It is also possible to write custom character to the LCD. It supports up to 8 characters of 5x8 pixels. We specify the appearance of each custom character by an array of 8 bytes. Okay, so for that we have to define an array of bytes like this. I will name it slash, as our custom character will look like slash. So here, this B stands for a binary formatter, and the 5 numbers are actually the pixels, the 5 pixels, and we need 8 more of, 7 more of this, so total 8, so that we get that format of 5x8 pixels. Okay, and now what we will change here from 0 to 1, that will create our custom character. So I will change it like this, and that will look as a slash. Now that one we have to initialize or create that custom character in the setup using the create char function like this, and here we need two parameters. The first parameter is a number from 0 to 7, or we have to reserve one of the 8 supported characters. So here I will just type 7, and as a second parameter it goes the name of the array of bytes we defined above, so that will be slash. And in the loop we will write our main program. I will make it look more interesting and make that character moves along the LCD. So we will use a for loop for changing the location of the cursor. So it will look like this. Okay, that's the for loop, and now using the set cursor function like this, lcd.setCursor. And here in the set cursor function we will use the I variable from the loop as a column parameter. And now we have to write that character, so using the lcd.write we'll write the character we defined above, so these two numbers have to be the same. I'll make 1 second delay, and clear the display after each iteration of the for loop. Okay, that's our program. Let's see how it works. Here's our custom character moving along the columns of the LCD. Thanks for watching, and for more tutorials, visit my official website howtomechatronics.com.